Yo, it's Cleverlike here with a quick tutorial on how to make your own Minecraft add-ons for Pocket Edition and Windows 10 edition of Minecraft. I created this video to go quickly for people that are already familiar with using the computer and doing some coding. So if you need it to go a little bit slower, check out my Getting Started video, which goes more step-by-step through all of the different pieces that you need. On this video, I'm going to move a little bit faster, so let's get started. First thing to do is go to the Minecraft website and then select Add-ons. We're going to grab a vanilla version of the add-ons files, which are here down at the bottom, and then I'll click Behavior Pack to download that behavior pack, and then I will show it in Finder. Okay, and so now I've got it here, and I will extract all, and I'm going to extract it to my behavior packs folder. And so to find that, if you don't know, it's on the C drive, so in under the user directory, so C users, and then the username, then app data, which is a hidden folder, then local packages, Minecraft. So pause the video, check out that path to go there, and then put this com.mojang into your quick access bar, okay? That'll save you some time in the future. We'll go to behavior packs in here, and then I'm gonna say new folder, and I'm gonna type big cows, because we're gonna make big cows. All right, and I am going to select that folder, and I'm gonna extract to that folder. So now we're extracting the basic standard Minecraft files to that folder, so there's really no behavior changes yet. Now what we need to do is start to change the code. These are all JSON files, which is a text file, but it's kind of code formatted, so you have to make sure to do the edits correctly. So what I recommend is checking out the Visual Studio Code product, or use your own code editor. But Visual Studio Code, it's free and it's got some nice attributes to it, so that's what I'm going to use. So let's go check that out. So from there, I'm going to open up the entire folder, big cows, so I could see all the files. And so you could see we've got all the JSON files for entities and then the loot tables. All of our customization is right here in this folder. And so first thing we need to do, though, is do some housekeeping and update our manifest file. So the manifest file is going to have some unique IDs that need to be unique specifically to your add-on. And the way to create those IDs is to get a unique UUID. And I've created a generator for that on my website, so cleverlike.com/UUID. Every time you refresh the page, it comes up with a brand new, completely unique, one-of-a-kind ID. So I'm going to copy that one, and I'm going to go back to the code, and I'm going to paste it. So I don't want you to copy mine. I want you to go get your own from that website. So if you have one that's a duplicate, you forget to change that, your add-on pack won't show up. It just won't show up if there's a conflict. You don't get an error message or any kind of information. It just doesn't show up. So if you do it wrong, that will be your problem. So big cows and lots of beef. Okay, and so now we've got our pack defined, and now we have the actual behavior pack itself being defined and also needs a new ID. So we say big cow behavior. So let me go get this new UUID. I'll refresh the page, highlight it, and bring it back over, paste, good, that's in. Now this is for the texture pack, the resource pack. We're not going to be doing any resource pack changes, so I'm just going to remove it from the manifest file. So delete, make sure you delete that properly, keep that square bracket there, and we've got our right brackets, and I'll save. And so now we should be good seeing that as an option when we create a new world. Even though there's no changes, let's just see if big cows shows up as a thing. So if I go to behavior pack, there's big cows. Cool. All right, so it does exist. Let's go ahead and make some changes to it. So we're going to go here to the entities, and then we'll go to the cow. And here's our JSON file. So if this is familiar to you, then you can go ahead and start editing. One of the things I want to show people is if I select all of that copy, and then I go to cleverlike.com/Minecraft add-on editor, and I paste the code into this editor, you could see that you can browse the data a little more clearly. So you could see here that cow baby has a scale attribute that's half size, but the adult does not. So why don't we copy that scale to the adult and then make it something big? So we could do that over on the code side as well. So if we go over to the scale, here it is, right? So I'll copy these three lines, and I'm going to go to the adult here, and we'll copy it here. And then we'll make the cows big. So the adult cow is going to have a scale of 5 now. We just created that customization. And so now what I'm going to do is save that, and then let's go create a new world based on that. Actually, one more quick thing. I hate to avoid this part, but let's make lots of beef here. So the cow is going to, for its loot, is going to drop leather. So we can say how many leathers. So let's say like 10 to 20 leathers. And then there's an enchantment rate. We won't change that. And then beef, we could say like 20 to 30 beef. All right, so let's save that. So we changed the loot table as well. And now I'm going to go, I don't have Minecraft running, so I'm going to run that. And play. We're going to create a new world. And we'll call it burgers. Well, that's not very nice, is it? But then creative mode. So we got the cheats on creative mode. And then let's make sure that behavior pack gets added into the world. And then we could say create. So let's see if we got some big cows going on over here. And, oh, yep, there they are. Look at that. Wow, that's a big cow. And so if I say, all right, yeah, I think I will. Thank you for that. Sorry. Oh, there he is. Okay, let's see what he's dropped here. I'm going to go here and clear out my hotbar, and let's take a look. Oh, I'm in creative mode. But there you go. 22 raw beef and 17 leather. That's a big cow. You deserve it. That'll feed a family for quite some time. So there you go. That is how you take it from the beginning. Create your own Minecraft add-ons for Pocket Edition and Windows 10. Leave a like if you found this video helpful, and definitely subscribe because I've got lots more behaviors and resource packs and more coding coming up in this channel. So thanks again for joining, and we'll see you in the next video.